This tutorial is a short introduction to the quality control of raw reads. So after listening to this video, you will be able to describe different types of quality problems in the FASTQ file format, and you will be able to list tools for both checking and improving read quality. So what kind of problems are there and why should we care? Well, so first of all, when the sequencing machine makes base calls, it's not always 100% confident in the call. And these confidence levels are recorded as base qualities. If the machine is not able to decide at all what call to make, it will just put N instead of one of the four bases. On the other hand, there can be also adapters and primers left in the reads, and these we obviously need to remove prior to analysis. So knowing about the potential problems in your data allows you to correct for them before you waste a lot of time on the analysis. And of course, not all problems can be corrected, but at least you can take them into account when interpreting the results. So let's look at the FASTQ file format. When you get your reads, they typically come in a FASTQ file, which is zipped, so it will have this ending. And it's important to note that you should not unzip the FASTQ files, so Chipster can cope with the compressed format. Now, in the file, there are always four lines per read. So there is the actual read sequence. Then there is a line starting with at sign, giving the read name. Each read has a name. The name can be repeated on the third line, or there is just a plus sign. And then the fourth line is the actual quality information. So each base has a quality value. These qualities use the PRET quality scoring system, where the formula is such that we take log 10 of the probability that the base is wrong. So let's say that if this was a 1 in 100 chance that it's wrong, and we would take log 10, that would be minus 2. Then we multiply that number by minus 10. So in this case, in our example, we would end up with 20. So this way, each base gets a PRET quality score, which would be these numbers here. But rather than listing these numbers in the FASTQ file, we convert them in order to save space to these ASCII characters. This is called Sanger encoding. So it has been just decided that we add the number 33 to each of these scores, and then take the matching ASCII character and put it in the file. So for example, if we had a base whose PRET score was 39, we would add 33 to it, which would make 72. And then we would take the 72nd ASCII character, which happens to be capital H, and put this to the FASTQ file. So here we have the ASCII alphabet starting from the 33rd character, which is the exclamation mark. So we just say that this equals to base quality of 0, and then go up from here. So base quality of 40, which is very good quality, is indicated by capital I. If you have older Illumina data, then there are other converting systems which are shown here. So let's look at the tools that you can use to check the sequence quality. So in the quality control category of Chipster, there is a tool called Read Quality with MultiQC for many FASTQ files. So this tool can take many FASTQ files as input. It's advisable to put them in a tar package and give the tar package as an input. And then it will run behind the scenes a tool called FASTQC for all these FASTQ files simultaneously. The FASTQC tools checks for many different things, including base quality and composition, duplication levels, and skimmers, adapters, and so on. There is also a tool called Statistics for Primers and Adapters with Tag Cleaner. So for this tool, you give the adapter a primer sequence, and it will check how many of your reads have it, and it will also look for mismatches. So as a result, you get a table like this. So here I have I had a look at the 5' primer, and it tells me that roughly 55,000 of my reads had this primer, and about 2,000 reads had it with one mismatch. So all in all, about 99% of my reads have it, which means that I will have to go and remove this primer from my reads before continuing the analysis. So I mentioned that for the MultiQC tool, you need to put your files in a tar package, or it's a good idea to do so. And there's actually a tool for this in the utilities category, make a tar package. So when your package is ready, then you can actually delete the original FASTQ files so that they don't crowd your workflow view. Like if you have hundreds of files, it would be very messy otherwise. And of course, afterwards, if at any time you want to look at the individual FASTQ files, you can also always open the tar package and look at them. So when your tar package is ready, you can give it to the MultiQC tool, which is a very rich tool with many features. It produces very nice interactive plots. In the plots, often you are able to say if you want to view either the numbers or the percentages of reads in the different files. MultiQC also gives you traffic lights, so like red and green, which is meant to indicate if your data is good or bad from different points of view. But you need to remember that these traffic lights are very general. So MultiQC doesn't know, for example, that you might have amplicon sequencing data. So you need to keep that in mind. So be a bit critical of the traffic lights. MultiQC also has a toolbox, which you can open by clicking on the right side panel, where you can highlight samples of FASTQ files, select which ones you particularly want to view. You can download plots, rename samples, and so on. And there is actually also a link in the MultiQC result page itself to a tutorial video, which is very useful, and it's made by the MultiQC developers. So let's have a look at some examples. So here we have a MultiQC plot per position base quality. And we have 10 FASTQ files. Now, according to MultiQC, 5 of them are okay and 5 of them are not. And if you look at this plot, so now on the x-axis, we have the position, base position in the read. So these reads are like 250 bases long. And then on the y-axis, we have the quality score. So you can see that in some FASTQ files, the base quality remains high in each of these positions, whereas in some FASTQ files, the base quality deteriorates towards the end, which is very useful, for example, for Illumina sequencing. Here we have another plot, sequence count plot from MultiQC. So now on the x-axis, we have the number of reads, and on the y-axis, the different FASTQ files. And as you can see, for some files, we have lots of, and some samples, we have lots of reads, almost 20,000 here. Well, for some we have less than 4,000, so it varies. MultiQC also covers these bars, showing how many of these reads are unique and how many are duplicates, meaning that there are identical reads in that particular file. And on the right hand side here, you can see the toolbox. So if you click here, you will get a new menu with lots and lots of options. So if you detect a quality problem, what can you do? Well, you can basically either trim or filter the reads. If you filter, it removes the entire read, while trimming removes only the bad quality bases or the adapters. Of course, the trimming can actually remove the entire read if all the bases are bad. So that's something to take into account. It's a fact of life that trimming makes reads shorter. So we need to keep this in mind because we typically want long reads. So we shouldn't trim them too heavily. And if we have parent data, so my sig data, for example, then we need to preserve the matching order of the reads in the two files, so in the R1 and R2 file. So what this means is that if the filtering or trimming removes a read from, say, R1 file, then its pair has to be removed from the R2 file, even if it would be a good one, because we need to keep the order. The different types of tools you have in the pre-processing category include Trimmomatic and PrintSig, which can cope with paired end data, like I just explained the paired end data issue. Of these two, Trimmomatic is faster. Then there are FASTX-based tools. FASTX is not able to take the pairing into account, but it doesn't matter if you are just doing a very simple trimming. So if you are trimming, for example, a certain number of bases from either end of the read, so then you are not missing the order of the reads, and hence you can use FASTX also for paired end data. Tag cleaner, on the other hand, is able to remove primers and adapters, and it also allows mismatches, which you can control with the parameters. So let's look at the Trimmomatic in more detail. So with Trimmomatic, you can remove adapters, you can do different types of quality trimming. So you can trim like one base at a time, looking at the quality, or you can look at the sliding window from either end. There is also a fancier sort of optimizing method for this. You can also filter based on minimum read quality, or you can just simply trim certain number of bases from either end. And importantly, you can request a minimum read length after trimming. So if the read becomes too short by your standards, it's just removed from the file. And like I said earlier, Trimmomatic can cope with paired end data.